On the count of three, can we all just say Happy New Year? Don't stop. What is up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Can y'all believe it is 2018? Y'all, where did 2017 go? I mean, I know everybody says this, but this year has went by so fast. I'm so glad to be out of 2017. You just get a blank canvas to really create and decide what type of year you want to have, what type of story you want to create for that year. So excited to be going into 2018, you guys. So, you know, we are in a new year, and of course, I had to get a little festive and do a little extra. Y'all, my little headband. I tried to get a New Year's, Happy New Year headband, something, you know, festive for the new year. I waited last minute and they were all sold out. And this is the closest thing I can find. So you know what? We're just gonna work with this girl's rule because, I mean, we do rule. So yeah, y'all, I wanted to pop this year off by making a video about the things that I learned in 2017. Of course, 2017 was another year of just growing and figuring out myself, figuring out the things that I want for myself. I learned some things. Yeah, I'm gonna stop jabbering, so let's get right into this video. So first up on my list is don't believe the hype. And what I mean by that is that 2017 taught me that you cannot believe everything that you see on social media. Social media is something that is one of those bittersweet things because, yeah, it gives you an outlet to connect to, you know, a variety of people and just network and build your brand and whatever the case may be. But it also can be one of those things that is very detrimental to your self-esteem, to how you view yourself, to how you look at your life, to comparing yourself to others. You have to realize people show you a tiny snippet of their lives on social media. People show you what they want you to see on social media. Just understand that people are showing you a highlight reel of their life. You're not seeing how they are behind closed doors and what they're doing. You're not seeing their character. You're not seeing them as a person. You're seeing what they want you to perceive them to be. And oftentimes, that image that they're putting out is not in line with who they really are. Majority of the time is not real. You don't know those things, so you have to take what you see on social media literally with a grain of salt. Don't let social media cause you to feel inadequate or feel like you're less than, like you're not beautiful, like you don't fit into that standard of beauty. I just learned that you cannot use social media to compare yourself to someone else's life. Just be able to distinguish reality from social media. Sis, don't believe the hype. The next thing that I learned is to stay in your lane. Stop looking over to the left and to the right to see what the next person is doing. Focus on what you have in front of you, what God has put in front of you, and try your best to use all the resources you have to accomplish what you want to do. If you're not walking in your purpose and your light, if you're trying to be like somebody else, imitate what they're doing because you see them, you know, moving on the fast track and they're starting businesses and they're, you know, getting opportunities and they're doing collaborations with companies and they're moving up in their career and whatever the case may be. So you're trying to do what they're doing. It's never gonna work for you because you're not them. Work at being the best version of yourself. You cannot get to where you're destined to go looking over in someone else's lane and trying to be like them. You cannot compare your chapter one to someone else's chapter 20. And when I saw that on Instagram, it was like so profound to me because you have to trust the pace that God has you moving. You have to trust in your own journey. Figure out what it is that you want. What are your passions? What are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? And work at that. You have to stay in your lane. Even when it seems like nothing is happening, even when it seems like everybody around you is passing you up and you're still here stuck trying to figure out what you're doing, and you know, don't even know the direction you want to go in life, and everybody is setting their careers and whatever the case may be, trust your process. Pray about it. Your journey, your pace that you're moving in your life is going to be different than someone else's. That is another one of the main things that I learned in 2017, is not to compare yourself. Just don't do it, because nothing good comes from it. Just don't do it, y'all. We need to leave that in 2017 as well. Okay, so show of hands, how many of us made New Year's resolutions at the start of 2017 and didn't really stick with them, or didn't really accomplish all the things we were trying to do because we either stopped halfway through, or we didn't fully commit to it, or whatever the case may be, they didn't get done. How many of us did that last year? Yeah, I know I did. Definitely made resolutions. What started out really strong, sticking with them in the beginning of the year, by the middle of the year, non-existent. And what I learned from that is nothing is going to change unless you do. Y'all, but seriously, I mean, we cannot expect things to change in our lives if we continue to do the same things, keep the same bad old habits, not commit to making changes, not commit to, you know, sticking it out, not to commit to our resolutions. Every year I make resolutions, and don't get me wrong, I'll, you know, accomplish some of them, but I mean, I have a whole list of resolutions. Majority of them don't get done, and the reason is, I keep the same bad habits. I just kind of kept doing the same behavior, expecting different results, when it really doesn't work like that, you know? In a lot of areas of my life, I've grown a lot this year. And in the areas that I did make changes, I see improvements. In the area that I didn't, and I didn't stick with it and commit to it and dedicate myself to it wholeheartedly, I don't see any improvements. I'm sure you guys are kind of in the same boat. The majority of you guys probably, you know, have some areas of your life that you can relate to. 2018, baby, ain't nobody got time for that. We need to make these changes, seriously. And last but not least, you guys, one of the final things that 2017 taught me was, don't dim your light. Don't be afraid of greatness. Don't be afraid of unleashing the potential that you have inside of you. Don't be afraid of trying new things. Don't be afraid of stepping out there and, you know, stepping outside of your comfort zone and, you know, being uncomfortable. It might sound crazy, but sometimes people can be afraid of what they have inside of them. They can be afraid of what comes when, you know, great things start happening in your life. You can kind of get afraid of them and kind of like put the hawks in them a little bit. If you know you're good at something, display that. Let people know. Promote yourself shamelessly. Don't be afraid of the spotlight, basically. I think in 2017, I kind of was, you know, afraid a little bit. I was a bit afraid of what could happen if I did this. Don't be afraid of new opportunities that present themselves and new experiences. Don't be afraid of people's opinions and people's criticism. Whatever it is that you want to start, just do it. But don't dim your light. Don't set limitations on yourself. Just don't be afraid of greatness, y'all. Don't be afraid of what comes with greatness. And in the process of you doing it and try something new and stepping out on faith, trust yourself. Believe in yourself. Know that you are enough. Know that you can do whatever it is you put your mind to do. It's enough room for all of us to be on the same platform and everybody's light to shine just as bright. You don't have to dim someone else's light because you feel like they're taken away from your own, or because you feel like they're shining a little brighter than yours. You don't have to do that. God has already placed whatever it is that you need to fulfill your purpose inside of you. You just have to look within yourself and recognize that. Just don't dim your light. And in the process of you stepping out on faith and, you know, stepping out into the unknown and putting yourself in uncomfortable positions, you know, whether that be new business opportunities and new experiences or whatever the case may be, be unapologetic about it. Be shameless about it. Shamelessly promote yourself. And that is really what I strive to do in 2018. I am so looking forward to this year, not only for myself, but for you guys. And guys, as always, if you enjoyed this video, if you, you know, learned some things about yourself or about your life, whatever the case may be, in general, then go ahead, give me a big thumbs up and leave me a comment down below so we can talk about them. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see y'all in the next video. Bye guys.